आई एम डॉक्टर प्रीति पागेती, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन महेश्वरी गर्ल्स पीजी कॉलेज. व्यूअर्स डिमांडेड दैट दे वांट टू लिसन द लेक्चर ऑन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स प्लानिंग, अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक ऑफ एचआर, एंड दिस वुड बी हेल्पफुल फॉर द प्रिपरेशन पीपल फॉर एज वेल एज एमबीए एस्पिरेंट्स आल्सो, दैट व्हाट इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स प्लानिंग. इट इज बेसिकली अ टॉपिक ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, हाउ द पीपल बी इन कॉर्पोरेट. सो it is major policy of HR basically. Let's speak about what is HRP, that is human resource planning. Human resource planning is something where we are talking about the efficient number of employees, efficient number of people who are working in an organization. Now that can only be possible when there is right person at the right place and the right time for fulfilling the organizational objectives. So it deals with anticipating the staff requirements, taking into account the current and likely future demand, what is my current demand and what would be the future demand of the employees for their skills, and the probable availability of individuals with such skills, what my individual holds such skills, that is the big question. So human resource planning basically, it is a very challenging position because it fulfills the current position and the desired position, the gap between these two, the current and desired. This is the work of human resource planning. However, there are three basic steps, my dear friends, which involves in this human resource. First, you need to assess what is the current human resource. Abhi at present, what number of people you have in your organization, that is there. Then you need to assess what is the future human resource. आगे आने वाले टाइम में how many human resource, how many people you require in your organization, and then it is developing a program to meet such future human needs. That means what kind of program you need to develop to meet such needs. Because let's say currently you have 50 employees, and in future you see ki there would be expansion of business, and let's say I would be opening up new outlets and I require 100 more employees. That is basic future demand. So you need to develop a program that how to meet that gap between 50 and 100. That is, you need to develop a program to meet such future human needs. Now there are key features or the basic features which are involved. First is strategy. What kind of strategy is involved? What kind of strategy, that is what kind of policy, because every organization holds a different policy. Now what kind of policy you will be employing for holding this human resource, like for employing the people in the organization. Then comes whether it will be internal recruitment, whether it will be external recruitment, what kind of policy. Policies and programs should be well defined and well circulated to all the employees as well who work in the organization. Then we need to forecast. Now forecasting is just knowing an estimate in advance and what is going to happen in future. But for that we need to have a proper current data available in the organization. What is it currently? That is the forecast. Only then the forecast can be done properly. Right people at right time. Now this is very important. You are employing a person, but the person is not being trained well. So that means you have wasted your time, you have wasted your energy, you have wasted your resources. So right people at right time, that is the right selection, is very important, and that can help only can happen when you have a proper human resource planning. Now that is the reason we say that human resource is a very qualitative approach. No doubt we have the quantity in number, but we need to have the quality, and this quality can only be achieved when we have right people at right time and in right place. It's a corporate plan because people generally, the human resource planning, we generally say it is a part or it is a need of a corporate plan. Companies need to hire people. It is a part of your HR policy as well. And then it is a continuous process. Employees can come, they go, they leave, but yes, organizations keep on running with handful of good employees. It is a continuous process. Organizations never stop. Next comes, it fills the human resource gap, as I already said that it fills the gap between what is the current resource and what is the future requirement. So filling the gap, again important. And then comes control of cost. Yes, cost can be controlled when we provide a proper training to the employee. And when we place the right employee at the right place, yes, the cost can be controlled because we need not hire more and more of people every time. Then the last future need of manpower. Yes, definitely human resource planning deals with what is going to be required for the future human power need. Because if we are not able to anticipate what is the future demand, we will not be able to know that what is the gap between the current position and what is the desired position. With this, I end with human resource planning. In the next video, you will be learning about the objectives, about the key role and its importance. Till then, thank you, and please like and subscribe. Thank you.